Hi, this is Jeff coming to you from Route 66 Homestead. We're going to be covering a few things on this little video. Hopefully it'll be useful to you all. One of the things we're going to cover is we're going to teach you how to take a 2-liter bottle and make it into a mini greenhouse. We'll also be doing the starts from some of our milkweed seeds that we've had put away for over 30 days now, stratifying in the refrigerator, which is important for most of the varieties of milkweed and a lot of other native perennial plants here in Illinois. So let's get started. So we're going to start our milkweed seeds early this year. It's middle of December now, and a lot of these milkweed seeds will not flower their first season unless you give them a head start. Like tomato plants, stuff like that, it's too early for those kind of things to be planted right now. But for things such as these flowering milkweed plants, it's so beneficial to our monarch butterflies. We'll be getting them started early and hopefully have some size and get some flowers at first season to help bring in the monarchs. Basically, I'm using a seed starting potting mix. You can use regular potting soil. That's no big deal. They do tend to flower a little quicker and a little better in the seed starting mix, but I grow a lot of my stuff from start and seed just using regular potting soil. When it comes to your water, make sure you let the water gas out if you have chlorine. We live on the edge of town, so we have chlorine water from the city. So make sure you let that sit out for 24 hours without the cap at a minimum to help gas out some of those chlorine. I've got several bags of the milkweed seeds in the fridge, stratifying. They've been going for over 30 days now. I also have some cardinal flower plants in there that are going to take a little bit longer to stratify, and I think those are 90 days, so it'll be probably mid-January before I can get those started. So we'll get started here in just a minute and show you what we do. We're going to start off with this bottom tray, and basically this sits down inside. Now what you want to do is you want to fill this 3/4 full with your potting mix and wet it down to where it's just damp, not flooded. And then you proceed from there. So we've got our base soil in now, and we've got 2 to 4 seeds in each one of these. So what we're going to do now, so we're going to take some soil and we're just going to barely cover the tops of them. And after doing that, we'll cover with the dome and it'll be prepared to go underneath our grow light on a heat mat. After topping off the soil just lightly on top, you need to go around with a spray bottle so as not to disturb the soil and just spray everything down. And another thing to remember is with these, you're going to have some issues sometimes, and a lot of people have problems losing their plants because of a disease called dampening off. And basically what that is your plants get too wet after they sprout and they get a fungus that chokes them off. So what you want to do is you always want to water from the bottom. You can give light sprays every once in a while, but you just want to have enough so that these packs can seed up from the bottom, and that should be plenty. And I won't let this set in here. I'll let it water good, and then I'll dump off the excess into one of my other containers downstairs for plants. So when trying to germinate, you want to cover it with a dome. These are so beneficial for helping in the process with the heating mat, keeping that moisture level in there, keeping a nice humid environment. My suggestion would be, if you've got one with one of these flaps, is to keep it closed until you see a heavy condensation build up. And then once you see that heavy condensation build up, you can open the lid every few days, let some of that drain back onto the seeds. And you can also crack this a little bit at that point, but just to to eliminate some of that extra moisture in there. After you got everything watered down, don't forget to put the name tag in of what you've got planted. It will come in beneficial down the road. We're back in the basement. I've got my heat mat set up. I've got it set at 75 degrees. These are one of the VivoSuns. You can get them without the controller, or you can get the extra controller to go along with it so you can set the temperature. I'm not sure what temperature range they run without the controller, but I wanted to be safe. And this one bounces around between 74 and 77. I do have a heater running down here in this room to keep it roughly 70 degrees, so there is a little variance with this, so keep an eye on it first. But I got my first batch of milkweed seeds ready to go. Now, a lot of times, you'll want to keep these 2 to 3 inches above if you're using just standard shop lights, which you can do. I've got 2 shop lights, but I've also got 2 Barina grow lights here that I got suspended from the ceiling. With the grow lights, you can be a little further away. I'm guessing I'm probably about 7-8 inches away, actually. So that'll be fine for these. Once that cover comes off, that's one of the things you can keep an eye on. If your lights aren't close enough, those plants will get real leggy. And by leggy, I mean they will grow up tall, skinny, and they'll start to fall over, and they'll just look disproportioned. If you keep the light close enough, though, they get bushier, and it's a much healthier looking seedling, which is going to produce a much healthier plant. I also want to talk to you about taking a 2-liter bottle and making a mini greenhouse to help germinate. Basically, all I did was I cut the bottom off along the line, and I've got the base for excess overflow. I've got a Canna Lillies seed in here. So what I do, I'm trying to get this to germinate. So I'm going to put this in the center between the 2 lights, because it needs that heat as well to germinate. Now, I've started a lot of these seeds. These seeds are 4 years old. I lost all my canna bulbs a few years ago during a move. I have no idea what happened to them. They must have got tossed. But there's a process with Canna Lillies seeds that you can go through. There's several YouTube videos out there. What I recommend is a blending of both. They're very hard shells. So you want to take a file or some sandpaper to that seed, and we're talking Canna Lillies, and you want to just rub on it until you can see the white center. At that point, you take boiling water and you pour it over the seeds for 20 seconds. You run it through cold water, and then you repeat that again. What that does is that breaks that hard shell, and it allows for germination. At that point, you soak those seeds in water until you see a white tip sticking out of it. And I will add that picture so you can see what it looks like here. As these develop, as you can see here, I've got several more Canna Lillies growing along back here. And I have a couple more advanced ones down here. I've got this one, and then I've got this one that I've got in a 2-gallon pot. I've moved that one to the floor. It's getting enough light coming from these lights sitting on the floor that it's continuing to thrive. I also, towards the end of the season, when we were cleaning up our flower beds, and I thought, you know, it'd be great to get some cuttings from the rose bushes. So I took 4 cuttings. I took 2 from the peach and 2 from the red. And as you can see, they're doing great. Now, normally, I would have used my rooting compound and put them in the soil. Well, the problem is I took these cuttings and I completely forgot about them. I had them in water, and they just took off on their own. They're just starting to root. So at this point, I'm going to let it continue to do what they're doing. once they get a root development, I'll then move them to a big pot and allow those to continue to grow so I can replant them next year into the garden. So hopefully today, here we've been able to help you with a few things to help you get started. It is December. Start thinking about that garden. You might want to get those seeds ordered. One great place is Baker's Creek. You can go online, sign up. They'll send you a free catalog. There's several others out there. They are a great resource, though, however, and I intend to be ordering my vegetable garden seeds sometime later this week. So please give all comments below. You know, if you have any questions, any suggestions, we're always learning. And please like and subscribe if you like this and you want to see more like this in the future. I want to thank you all for watching. Have a great day. What?